What does a $4 billion budget shortfall mean for education funding in Pennsylvania? I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me this hour is Pennsylvania State Representative Jim Roebuck. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you.
Let's talk a little bit about where we stand in terms of education funding in this budget process. For you, I know this is a priority, but there's been discussion about potentially implementing a voucher-type program for some students in Pennsylvania. You recently had a panel discussion related to this.
Yes, we did. There have been a number of efforts to address the problem of the lack of student achievement. And one of the arguments is that one way you do that is that you allow students to escape failing schools by giving them vouchers, which would allow them to go to other schools. The reality, however, is that vouchers don't guarantee you anything. There is no real guarantee that there are slots for students in alternative schools, nor is there any requirement in the current legislation that we're looking at that would require a school to take a student. You could arrive at the front door of a school, your voucher in one hand, your kid in the other, and that school could still tell you no. So there is no sense here in my mind, no reality in my mind as to what vouchers would do.
What about the funding related to vouchers? Where would the money come from if the state is facing such a budget shortfall?
That's a good question. I don't think that the proponents have been clear on how they're going to raise that money. The sense is that it would come out of the general education appropriation. So you'd be reducing money for school districts in order to create this special entitlement. And there would be, at the same time, no guarantee that giving kids vouchers would do anything substantially to improve their educational opportunity.
But then what are the alternatives for parents who are unhappy with their child's education, for kids who are struggling or are in a failing school?
I think that's a real challenge for those of us who shape public policy to find that way in which we can offer to parents good options. Certainly the public schools generally across the state are improving. They're not where they should be. And we have to continue to look at ways to make them better. But it's clear to me at the same time that giving a parent a voucher does not give them the opportunity that many of the proponents are suggesting they'll get.
So moving from K to 12 educational funding to higher education funding, you were recently reappointed to the board of the Community College of Philadelphia. You have universities in the district that you represent. Talk to us a little bit about where we stand in terms of higher ed funding and why you feel that's important for the development of a workforce.
Given the limits of state resources, we've reduced the funding for most higher education institutions, or we've not certainly increased them as we have been in the past. And that's a challenge. More and more, the emphasis for young people seeking a higher education is upon community colleges. They're more affordable, they're more accessible. And so I would hope that we can continue to fund those at a reasonable level and offer to young people that as a first step, allowing them to go on to a four-year education.
And let's talk a little bit about this budget process and what it will mean for education funding. What do you see happening as we progress into the next month?
I would like to believe that we could keep education funding at least level, if not slightly increase it. We've had great success in Pennsylvania in improving the quality of education. We have put a substantial money into basic education, into as well as into kindergarten education. So we've become a leader in those fields. If we are to reduce funding, then we're going to ultimately step backwards. The key is to strengthen what we have so that young people will have an opportunity to get a foundation, to get a good education, and become productive citizens in our society.
And just a few seconds left, but will there be a focus on special education funding as well?
Certainly special education needs to be included in that. And we have to look at the way we deliver special education services to young people.
Come back, give us an update. Let us know how this conversation is progressing. Thanks for being with us. We've been talking with Pennsylvania State Representative Jim Roebuck. I'm Jill Horner for Comcast Newsmakers.